Tired of programmed drums that sound like this? And they get lost in the mix like this. You need to learn how to mix sampled drums. Hey guys, Joey here, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to mix drums inside the sampler. Drum sampling has come really far since the early days. Not only can drum sounds be created from a plugin, but they can also be mixed. This has all sorts of benefits like saving CPU, having cleaner sessions, and making faster decisions. Integrating this into your workflow is a great way to have better sounding drums faster. You're watching this on the DrumForge YouTube channel, so obviously I'm going to be using DrumForge Matt Griner, but the tips here apply to any DrumForge sampler and even a few other sampler plugins. So make sure you watch till the end and save this video. Now let's dive in. This video is going to assume that you already have a stellar MIDI performance. That can be created with an E-kit or manually entered into a piano roll. If you're still writing the MIDI, here's a few quick tips. Be cautious about the velocity and timing of notes. Experiment with lower velocities and hits that are slightly off the grid. This can lead to a more realistic result. We're also going to assume that you've already built the drum kit. Some plugins open with a full kit already loaded, and some make you build it from scratch. DrumForge Matt Griner defaults to Studio Kit 1 preset. But for this example, I'm actually going to use Studio Kit 1 dry preset. This contains the same kit, but has none of the mixing. These are super useful for designing your own EQ dynamics and ambience settings. The mics themselves have the biggest impact on the sound. Go through each drum and set the right balance of close mics, auxiliary mics, and room mics. Awesome! Even without processing, these already sound great. Now let's move on to the mixer window. A good workflow in this plugin is to start on each shell and cymbals channel, then make adjustments to each mic. The ability to process each mic separately is just one awesome feature of DrumForge Matt Griner. Start with the EQ on each channel. Think about where you want the low end to sit. Depending on where you boost or cut, the weight of the channel is affected. Now set the high end. This is where you'll decide how much clarity, clickiness, and crack each piece of the kit has. The last major EQ decision to make is how much mid-range a sound has. On more processed libraries, this will often already be done. Since we're using a raw preset, you get to make that decision yourself. Drums with more mid-range can stick out a little bit more in a mix, but they can also make a mix sound kind of muddy. Listen to the other mix elements and set this mid-range in context. I want to take a quick second to talk about hi-hats. Since they're so high-pitched, a lot of their weight actually comes from the mid-range. Check it out. A lot of people just filter this out for a brighter sound, and if you feel like the hi-hats are getting lost or just don't sound very big, check out this frequency region right here. Awesome! The balance in EQ is set. Now is a great time to dive into the individual mic tracks if there's anything still poking out. And here's a hint, pay special attention to the EQ on the snare bottom and cymbal room mics. They usually need a bit of processing to sound correct. In a sampler, you have complete control over the volume and the MIDI velocity and automation. So the goal of dynamics in these types of plugins is more to shape the sound rather than to make it consistent. The channel compressors in the DrumForge samplers make this super easy, giving you only the settings that you need. The biggest change in the sound comes from this switch right here. This changes how long it takes for the compressor to react. Slow attack will give a punchier sound, and fast attack will make it super tight. Where this plugin differs is on the FlexBus compressor. This adds some serious vibe and impact to your drums and cymbals. It's just one knob, so turn it up until it sounds amazing. Awesome. The next step is saturation. Saturating drums is a timeless trick that adds impact, size, and life to a drum performance. Experiment by adding tube saturation to make them softer, tape saturation to make them fatter, or distortion to make them harder. Once you've got a vibe you like, try taking it even further with clipping. In small doses, this is a volume maximizer. Drive it a little harder and it's a dynamics controller. Push it all the way and it's distortion. Go back and forth with these settings until you're getting the right balance of impact, vibe, and loudness. One of the last steps when mixing drums is designing the ambience. I'll usually start with a little bit on the snare and a little bit on the drum shell's bus. If the cymbals are too dry for the song, I'll simulate some room ambience on them too. If you want to experiment with parallel processing, you can actually do that inside of the mixer too. Just use the send feature and send anything that you want to process to a bus group. DrumForge Mac Griner has 8 bus groups to experiment with. Try sending all of the shells to a parallel shells bus and compressing it super hard with clipping and reverb. Then just balance it to the mix with the group's fader. Want the power of the DrumForge mixer, but still need to process with your own plugins? Just use the groups as mix buses and export them out of the plugin. DrumForge Mac Griner allows up to 16 stereo outputs, so you can combine our mixer with your own plugins. Just assign the output of each track or group to one of the outputs of the plugin, and make that the input for an aux track. Love working in the DrumForge mixer, but you don't want to start from scratch? Well, just load one of the mixed presets and build the rest of your mix around it. However you use the samplers, make sure you understand the mixing workflow. Mastering this skill will make your demos sound like finished records. If you need an amazingly feature-packed sampler where you can program drums and mix them at the same time, check out DrumForge Mac Griner. This tool gives anyone access to August Burns Red drummer Mac Griner's custom sounds. Download your copy today at the world's best online source for professional drum sounds and software, drumforge.com.